Welcome back. In this video, I will look at adding a child domain to an existing domain in Active Directory. Each child domain makes your network more complex and harder to administer. In the past, extra domains were created due to the limitations of how many objects Active Directory could have, especially in different groups. Active Directory has improved its ability to scale. Now it can scale to millions of objects. Another limitation was password policies. Previously, Active Directory supported one password policy per domain. Now you can create more than one password policy per domain, so before you create a child domain, ask yourself, why are you creating a child domain? When possible, it is best to stay with one domain. There are times when you need to add a child domain. In most cases, this will be because of business requirements. Active Directory gives you the ability to separate departments and even different companies into different management structures. In some cases, the business may decide they want different domains to keep business management separate. This may come down to different business units having different budgets, and this makes sharing resources, such as servers, difficult. Imagine asking the accounting department to split a new server bill between different companies. Now imagine the companies having different ideas about which hardware to buy. One company may want quality, reliable hardware, and the other wants to save money. In cases like this, it is often simpler to have two domains. The next reason you may want to create new domains is due to different IT support requirements. If your company deals with intellectual property or has a secure department, they may want a network that is completely separate from the main company. They may even hire their own IT staff to look after the network. One network I worked on had two such networks, the commercial network and the secure network. In some of the network cabinets in the company, they had network equipment from both the secure and the commercial networks. One day during routine maintenance, one of the support staff found a network cable had been put in place connecting both of the networks together. Probably just a mistake, but the cable was quickly removed. The security department then arranged to have another locked cabinet installed inside the first. This ensured the network equipment was separate and thus mistakes like this could not occur. When deciding if you should create a new child domain, ask yourself this. Would having just the one domain and having a small mistake like permissions set incorrectly cause the data in the domain to be compromised? If so, in some cases it is worth the extra money and resources to ensure that a little mistake will not allow your intellectual property to get into the wrong hands. You will sleep better at night knowing that you will have a job to come back to in the morning. Lastly, before creating a new child domain or removing one, consider the company's structure and how it may change in the future. One company that I did some work for decided to merge the child domain of another company with the parent domain to reduce costs. The company paid the other company a fee each year to manage the IT infrastructure. Once the two domains were merged into one domain, the second company decided to outsource their IT support. The change in the support agreement meant the two companies had to be separated into two domains again. If you want to save yourself some work in the future, consider the company's current structure and how it may change before starting the work. In this video, I will look at adding a child domain to ITFreeTraining. Currently, this is a single forest with a single domain. In this case, I will add a second domain called East ITFreeTraining. This will be a new child domain in the same forest. Since it shares the same namespace with ITFreeTraining, it is considered to be in the same tree as ITFreeTraining. I will now switch to my Windows server to demonstrate how to add the East child domain to the forest. Just like I did when I added my first domain controller, I need to run the command dcpromo from the start menu. Once I skip past the welcome and information screens, I can choose if I am adding this domain controller to an existing forest or a new forest. In this case, I will select the top option since I'm creating a child domain. If I were adding another domain controller to an existing domain, I could select the next option, Add a domain controller to an existing domain. Since I want to add a new child domain, I will select the next option, Create a new domain in an existing forest. On the next screen, I need to enter in a username and password that has enough access to add child domains. This will need to be someone in the Enterprise Administrators group. Usually, they will be found in the root domain, in this case, itfreetraining.local. If, however, they are located in a different domain, including a child domain, I can enter in the domain name here. At the bottom of the screen, I will press the Set button to enter in the username and password of the user that is in the Enterprise Administrators group. Then I will press Next. Windows will now ask for the parent domain of the new child domain. In this case, the root domain will be itfreetraining.local. Under this, I need to enter in the name of the domain itself, in this case, East. At the bottom, notice that Windows will show the fully qualified domain name as east.itfreetraining.local. When I press Next, Windows will contact the Domain Naming Master to ensure the domain name can be added. On the next screen, I can select the domain functional level. In this case, I only have two functional levels to choose from because my forest functional level is set to Windows Server 2008. The next screen will ask me which site this domain controller will go into. Later on in the course, I will cover sites. For now, I will accept the default option and move on. On the next screen, I can decide if DNS will be installed as well. I already have a Microsoft DNS server on my network, so I will deselect this and move on. I will receive a message telling me Windows could not find the DNS records for this domain in the DNS server. This is normal because they have not been created yet, so it is safe to ignore this message. The next screen will ask where I want to store the Active Directory database, log files, and the sysvol folder. I will accept the default locations for these and move on. Just like when I created the first domain controller, I will be asked for the Directory Service Restore Mode password. This is used to repair or recover Active Directory when things go wrong. Next, I will receive a screen confirming my options, and after I press Next, this server will become the first domain controller in the new child domain. The new child domain will be able to access resources in the parent domain, and the parent domain will be able to access resources in the child domain. Now that all the hard work is done installing Active Directory, in the next video, I will look at how to uninstall Active Directory. In most cases, you will simply be removing a domain controller from a domain. But if you want to completely remove Active Directory, I will show you how to do that as well. As always, thanks for watching our always free videos.